For Wall Street Media, I'm Mike, I'm here with Doug, and we'll help you make money in the stock market with information you can't find anywhere else.
Hey, we've got super great stuff coming from Roth in California.
News and highlights. For anyone that's interested, you can follow the full presentations by going to www.com/webcast/Roth20. First up, we have a video highlight. Philip Strawbridge, CFO of Energy Solutions, ticker is ES, talks about their federal services segment and recent government wins. Let's take a look.
Next is our federal services. What's happened is over the years, whenever the federal government pursued some of the weapons opportunities, they really messed up several hundred sites across the country. A lot of those have been cleaned up, but some of the dirtier ones are still left. There's still almost 100 sites that need to be decommissioned and taken down. If you look at the types of things we provide on these sites, they're on the right-hand side of the slide, facilities operations, material management, et cetera. But suffice it to say that the Department of Energy has, for the last many years, even under the Republicans, spent about $6 billion a year on cleanup. And what's occurred is us, a new company coming online, there are several new contracts that are coming up for bid. So we've been bidding and we've been winning our share. The other thing that's good about this particular thing is that in the economic stimulus bill that's all passed, there is $6 billion. So above the $6 billion annualized spending, there's an additional $6 billion to be spent over the next 2 years, so increasing that funding by 50%. We think that we'll be a major beneficiary of that. If you look at some recent wins, we've bid three different major contracts. We've won two, so good momentum going into some of these other opportunities. This is one we bid in conjunction with our teaming partner, URS. We have a 40% economic interest in this job. This is actually a long-term contract, but it's only 10 years for the period that we would manage, and then it'd be recompeted again. But $7.1 billion is the Department of Energy's estimate over a 10-year period. These are a list of those opportunities that I mentioned that are coming up. We think we'll lead several of them. We'll probably lead Portsmouth and Paducah especially, and probably the Oak Ridge Disposition Program. But you can see some very large contracts, all cost reimbursable under the Department of Energy, so really no exposure from a risk profile. The other thing that we have, and I'll only talk about it for a second, is what's called a recycling capability. There are three countries that still recycle spent fuel, Japan, Great Britain, and France. Great Britain, we acquired the technology through one of the acquisitions for the exclusive rights for recycling here in the United States, and we lead a team that's been getting money under what's called a GNEP, the Global Nuclear Energy Partnership, to advance the technology associated with it. This is a long-term opportunity. You know, it's 10 to 15 years down the road.
And we're back.
I like these guys. You know, innovative, man. They just offered a revenue share to the state of Nevada, which has a $320 million shortfall, if they'll do a deal with them to allow them to place some low-level waste there.
They certainly have enough space there, right, to do it.
All open desert, right?
Right.
I thought that was innovative. I think I like that kind of thinking from a management team in this kind of environment.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. We also have a couple of notes. John Norris, president and CEO of FuelTech, ticker FTEK, talked about their potential in China for reductions in emissions. He said the mother lode in FuelTech's movement into China will be January 2011, when China starts addressing the 4,000 units that are online now.
What did you say? Ha, ha, ha! Was that Chuck Norris?
Right, right.
Chuck Norris?
What do you mean, Chuck Norris?
Isn't that Chuck? Oh, John.
John.
Oh.
Preston Rom, CFO of Obagi... Yeah. Yeah. It's late, Doug, isn't it? CFO of Obagi Medical Products, ticker OMPI, explained that they have no debt and their market share is three times that of their main competitor in the skincare market. They're expanding into India and Brazil, both countries with huge market potential and a major growth opportunity. Peter Osborne, CFO of VNUS Medical Technologies, ticker VNUS, spoke about their strong fourth quarter revenue of $27.2 million in 2008, with a fourth quarter product revenue growth of 26% confirmed. He sees the market in demand and growth in the current economic climate.
Hey, God bless these guys, man. They were, I think, one of two American stocks up today. Well done.
They're in the green, right?
No.
Joseph Cooper, EVP of Corp and Product Development of Medicus Pharmaceutical Corporation, ticker MRX, discussed their fourth point growth strategy and their great success with Solodin. They recently acquired Ziposonics, with the body aesthetic market projected to grow rapidly within the next few years. Wing Kai Yap, CFO of China Security and Surveillance Technology, ticker CSR, sees cooperation as a key to future expansion and explained that they are both the first Chinese and the first NASDAQ company traded in Dubai. They plan to continue their focus on sustainable long-term growth. Peter Berlage, CEO of PMFG, ticker PMFG, talked about the recent acquisition of Nitram Energy, which has broadened the product portfolio and expanded the market position. He said that part of their growth strategy is to continue to pursue selective acquisitions while expanding their technology and product offerings, manufacturing processes, and enhance the pursuit of high growth market. James Limes, president and CEO of Graham Corporation, ticker GHM, talked about long-term demand growth drivers, saying that through 2015, they see environmental and feedstock diversification being main drivers of growth, while through 2030, ooh, that's a long time, they see capacity creep and 1% to 1.5% global demand growth driving them into the future. He also said they look to expand geographically and increase operational efficiency while selectively acquiring other businesses.
Hey, Roth just started these guys last Friday with a buy on them.
Okay. Well, buying these times means a lot, I think. Huh?
Yeah.
Steve Huge, chairman and CEO of Smart Balance, ticker SMBL, believes that its strategy of no compromise in taste and unparalleled depth of management has led to 28 quarters of consecutive share growth and count to tier growth margins. He also believes they have a sustainable competitive advantage from a strategic level. 28 quarters, that's nice. Daska Choudhury, CEO of Valent Pharmaceuticals International, ticker VRX, spoke about their focus on dermatology and neurology with differentiated product portfolios. Their IDP products will have phase 2 trials completed by the end of 2009. RX Atraline is a $782 million market and a large source of their revenue. Jeffrey Davison, CFO of RightNow Technologies, ticker RNOW, explained that they have continued to be a leader in e-service and is moving into customer service software, a market 6 times larger than e-service. Their current business model is aligned with customer success. Their land and expand strategy will be a source of revenue growth.
Yeah, Roth are big in the enterprise software guys. Mm-hmm. I think they had 4 of them yesterday, 2 today, and they're having like 16 of them tomorrow.
Mm-hmm. Wow.
So if you're an enterprise software investor, you should tune in. We'll have a lot more for you.
And we have the replay available. Again, if you want to listen to them, you can go to www.com/webcast/Roth20.
Are you sure that wasn't Chuck Norris?
That was not Chuck Norris. We're here every day at Wall Street Media. You can find us directly at wsmco.com. Thanks.